Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to find factorial of a number. Now, first of all, let's see what is factorial number. A factorial is a function that multiplies a number by every number below it. For example, so when I take a 5 here, so 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, these are the below numbers. So we need to multiply all the numbers below this actual number. Let's say 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, till 1 we have to multiply. And the total value will be 120. That is a factorial number. So we can go for either descending order or we can go for either ascending order. If you start from 5, we need to go and decrease each and every number and we need to multiply all the digits. Or if you're starting from the 1, we need to increase each and every number and multiply by each and every number, and finally we'll get the factorial of a number. So either we can go for this way or we can go for this way. Now I'll show you how to write a program to find a factorial number. Let's go to Eclipse. So here I'm just creating a new class. I will name it as factorial number. Now let's take a main method and then finish. So here to find the factorial number, so I can write either a while loop or I can also write a loop for loop. So I can use one of the loops. So first of all, I will show you by using for loop, and then we'll go for while loop. So here what I'm going to do is I'll create two different variables. Let's say integer number is equal to, let's say 5. So 5 is a number. I want to find factorial of the 5. And to store the factorial number, I will also take one variable. And I will define this variable as a long, because sometimes factorial will be very lengthy word or lengthy string, lengthy integer. So now if I take a normal integer variable, it cannot hold a long value. So I'm just taking long. And here I'll say factorial is equal to and 1. So initially I say factorial value is equal to 1. All right, so now let me write a for loop statement. I'll say for, and I will first go to this particular approach. Let's say I will go for lower to higher. Let's say when I want to find the factorial of the 5, I'll start from 1 starting number into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5. Right, so this will give you 120 as a factorial number. So now I'm again go to the same order. So here I'll start from 1. So here let's take an integer I value is equal to 1. Now when you just start multiplying this, once the I value reaches 5, and 5 is also should be considered, and then you need to stop. So here I will say condition I less than or equal to number. And then I'll increment the I value every time. Let's say I plus plus. So here I'll write one expression. Let's say factorial is equal to factorial into I. So this will calculate the factorial. And after completion of the loop, come outside of the loop. And here I'll say system.out.println. And here I'll say factorial of a number is, I can just print the factorial variable. This will print factorial. Right, so now let us see how it is going to work. Let me just put a debug point here. And once you put the, and let's run this in debug mode so that we can see each and every step how it is going to calculate. And right click, debug as Java application. So once you started, it stopped here. So we need to debug from it here. So just press function key F6 from your keyboard. It will go step by step. So initially here I value is equal to 1 and number is 5. I is equal to 1, which is matching this condition. Now it will enter into the loop. So once it is entered into this loop, so currently the value is factorial is 1. Initially we have taken factorial value 1, so it is 1. The I value is also 1, so 1 into 1, so the factorial will be 1. So here we capture 1. After that, again go up, then I value will become 2 now. So here I value become 2 here. Once you cross it, I value become 2 now. So 2 less than or equal to 5. So condition is true. Now again come inside. So here previously the factorial value is 1. Now the I value is a 2. So 1 into 2. So 2 into 1. So it will be 2 will be again assigned to the factorial. Now the current value of the factorial is 2. All right. So now again it will go up. Now the I value becomes a 3. Now here factorial, we already have 2 earlier. Now the I value is a 3. So 2 into 3, 2 threes are 6. So 6 will be assigned to the factorial. Now 6 will be assigned to the factorial. Now the current factorial value is 6. So after that, again F6. Now I value becomes 4. Now again 4 less than or equal to number. Condition is true. So again it will come inside. So here factorial is previously 6. Now the I value is 4. Now 6 4s are 24. So 24 will be assigned to the factorial. Now the latest value is 24. So again it will go up. And I value becomes 5. So this is the last number. We should multiply with this. Now 5 less than or equal to number. Condition is again true. Now it will enter into the loop. Now the factorial value is 24 previously. Now I value is 5. So 24 into 5, which is equal to 120. So 120 will be assigned to the factorial. So factorial will be 120 here. So after that, I value becomes 0. As soon as I value becomes 0, sorry, I value becomes 6. Previously, I value is 5. So now I plus plus means I value becomes 6. Now 6 less than or equal to number, the condition is false. Then it will exit from the loop. Then here the factorial value 120 will be printed as an output. So this is how we need to find a factorial of a number. So when I say 10 here, let me just conclude this. Okay, let me just remove the debug point. Let me give some other number. Let's say 10. I want to find factorial of the 10. Now let's execute this program once again. Right click, run as Java application. So now this is a factorial of 10. Right, so this is how we need to find factorial of a number. So we can also write the same logic in descending order. Let's say 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 also we can write. Suppose if you want to write in different way, we can write like this. Let me also write the another logic here. Let me just close this. Right, so I will show you how we can write the same logic in descending order. So I'll just comment this loop statement. Now I'll write one more for loop, and this time I'll show you in descending order. So if I want to start with the descending order, it will be like this, right? So let's say 5. It will be start from 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So which is again equal to 120. So now we need to go to descending order. So here initial value I need to start from 5. So exactly I'll say number is equal to 5. So 5 is a number. So I need to start from the 5. I'll slowly decrease till it reaches 1. So what I will do is here I will take I value starting from number. Okay, I'll say number. So that means here number I'm assigning to the I, because currently I value is a 5. So I'm starting from the 5. And here the condition is I'll say I greater than or equal to 1. Always I value greater than or equal to 1. And then I minus minus. We need to decrease the value by 1 every time. Now again, we have to use the same expression here. Now let's see how it is going to work. So let me just put the debug point here. I'll put debug point here on the for loop. Let's double click and it will insert the debug point. Now right click, debug as Java application. So now it is started debugging the code. So here it will stop. Let me run one more time. Right click, debug as Java application. Yeah, now it is stopped here. So initially, so num is 5. So I'm assigning the number value to the I. So once you cross this step, the condition is true here. See, this I value is 5, and 5 greater than or equal to 1, condition is true. Now here it will enter. Now the currently factorial value initially 1. So 1 into 5. So 1 into 5. 1 into 5, 5. So currently the factorial value is 5. So here I'm writing 5. So the current value of factorial is 5. After that, again, it will go up. Now I value becomes reduced by 1. So once you go up, now you can see I minus minus. So I value become 4. So the condition becomes true. So here also 4 greater than or equal to 1 condition is true. Now here, previously the factorial value is 5. Now the currently I value is 4. So 5 into 4, it becomes 20. So 20 will be assigned to the factorial. Now 20 is the current value of factorial. Now again, it will go up. Now I value becomes a 3. Once you cross, I value becomes 3 now. Again, 3 greater than or equal to 1, condition is true. So again here, factorial we have 20 earlier. Now currently I value is 3, so 20 into 3. So now once you cross this step, it will become 60, 20 into 3. Now the current value of the factorial is 60. Now again it go up. Now I value, once you cross this, I value becomes 2 now. It is decreased by 1. Now the 2 greater than or equal to 1, again condition is true. Now here previously the factorial value is 60. Now multiplying by 2, so 60 into 2, it becomes 120. So now the current factorial value is 120. So again it will go up. Now again I value reduced by 1. So I value 1, I greater than or equal to 1, again condition becomes true. So again it will enter into the block. So previously factorial value is 120. Now I value is a 1, so 120 into 1, still it is 120. So here again we'll get only 120. After that, again it will go up and I value decrease by 1. So now I value becomes 0. So here I value becomes 0 once you cross this. So as soon as I value becomes 0, then 0 greater than or equal to 0 condition is false. Then it will come out from the loop. And here the factorial variable contains the actual value, that is 120. Now it will print 120 as a factorial number. So this is how we can also write the logic. So we can just go for either ascending order, or we can go for descending order. So ultimate thing is we should able to multiply all the values below the number, right? So this is how we need to find factorial of a number. All right, so that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.